Good morning, my sisters and brothers. Welcome to another morning's devotion, service of matins, and you're sharing with the Pro-Cathedral and Parish of St. George with St. Barnabas. Thank you for joining and for sharing with us this morning. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
This is another day, O Lord. We know not what it will bring forth, but make us ready, Lord, for whatever it may be. If we are to stand up, help us to stand bravely. If we are to sit still, help us to sit quietly. If we are to lie low, help us to do so patiently. And if we are to do nothing, help us to do so listening still to you. Make these words more than words, and give us the Spirit of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We continue with our hymn, the hymn 511, 511. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see our God. 511. We turn now to our prayer books, page 32 in our prayer books. We recite together the second sentence. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and in the earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head above all. On page 35, we use section 2 for the versicles and responses. Section 2. Hear us, O Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We will exalt you, O God, our Savior,
and praise your name forever and ever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes. He comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness
and people with his truth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our psalm this morning is Psalm 78. Psalm 78, and we read verses 1 through 39, or what is considered as part 1. Psalm 78, verses 1 through 39. Hear my teaching, O my people. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth.
I will open my mouth in a parable. I will declare the mysteries of ancient times.
That which we have heard and known, and what our forefathers have told us, we will not hide from their children.
We will recount to generations to come the praiseworthy deeds and the power of the Lord, and the wonderful works he has done.
He gave his decrees to Jacob and established a law for Israel, which he commanded them to teach their children,
that the generations to come might know, and the children yet unborn, that they, in their turn, might tell it to their children,
so that they might put their trust in God, and not forget the deeds of God, but keep his commandments,
and not be like their forefathers, a stubborn and rebellious generation, a generation whose heart was not steadfast and whose spirit was not faithful to God.
The people of Ephraim, armed with the bow, turned back in the day of battle.
They did not keep the covenant of God and refused to walk in his law.
They forgot what he had done and the wonders he had shown them.
He worked marvels in the sight of their forefathers in the land of Egypt, in the field of Zoan.
He split open the sea and let them pass through. He made the waters stand up like walls.
He led them with a cloud by day, and all the night through with a glow of fire.
He split the hard rocks in the wilderness and gave them drink as from the great deep.
He brought streams out of the cliff, and the waters gushed out like rivers.
But they went on sinning against him, rebelling in the desert against the Most High.
They tested God in their hearts, demanding food for their craving.
They railed against God and said, "Can God set a table in the wilderness?"
True, he struck the rock, the waters gushed out, and the gullies overflowed. But is he able to give bread or to provide meat for his people?
When the Lord heard this, he was full of wrath. A fire was kindled against Jacob, and his anger mounted against Israel.
For they had no faith in God, nor did they put their trust in his saving power.
So he commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven.
He rained down manna upon them to eat and gave them grain from heaven.
So mortals ate the bread of angels. He provided for them food enough.
He caused the east wind to blow in the heavens and led out the south wind by his might.
He rained down flesh upon them like dust and winged birds like the sand of the sea.
He let it fall in the midst of their camp and round about their dwellings.
So they ate and were well filled, for he gave them craved.
But they did not stop their craving, though the food was still in their mouths.
So God's anger mounted against them. He slew their strongest men and laid low the youth of Israel.
In spite of all this, they went on sinning. and had no faith in his wonderful works.
So he brought their days to an end like a breath, and their years in sudden terror.
Whenever he slew them, they would seek him and repent and diligently search for God.
They would remember that God was their rock, and the Most High God their Redeemer.
But they flattered him with their mouths and lied to him with their tongues.
Their heart was not steadfast toward him, and they were not faithful to his covenant.
But he was so merciful that he forgave their sins and did not destroy them. Many times he held back his anger and did not permit his wrath to be roused.
For he remembered that they were but flesh, a breath that goes forth and does not return. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Amen. We now have our first reading from the book of Esther. First reading from the book of Esther.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Esther, chapter 5, reading verse 1 to verse 14. Esther 5, 1 to 14. On the third day, Esther put on her royal robes and stood in the inner court of the king's palace, opposite the king's hall. The king was sitting on his royal throne inside the palace, opposite the entrance to the palace. As soon as the king saw Queen Esther standing in the court, she won his favor, and he held out to her the golden scepter that was in his hand. Then Esther approached and touched the top of the scepter. The king said to her, "What is it, Queen Esther? What is your request? It shall be given you even to the half of my kingdom." Then Esther said, "If it pleases the king, let the king and Haman come today to a banquet that I have prepared for the king." Then the king said, "Bring Haman quickly, so that we may do as Esther desires." So the king and Haman came to the banquet that Esther had prepared. While they were drinking wine, the king said to Esther, "What is your petition? It shall be granted you. And what is your request? Even to the half of my kingdom, it shall be fulfilled." Then Esther said, "This is my petition and request. If I have won the king's favor, and it pleases the king to grant my petition and fulfill my request, let the king and Haman come tomorrow to the banquet that I will prepare for them, and then I will do as the king has said." Haman went out that day happy and in good spirits. But when Haman saw Mordecai in the king's gate and observed that he neither rose nor trembled before him, he was infuriated with Mordecai. Nevertheless, Haman restrained himself and went home. Then he sent and called for his friends and his wife Zeresh. And Haman recounted to them the splendor of his riches, the number of his sons, all the promotions with which the king had honored him, and how he had advanced him above the officials and the ministers of the king. Haman added, "Even Queen Esther, let no one but myself come with the king to the banquet that she prepared. Tomorrow also I am invited by her together with the king. Yet all this does me no good so long as I see the Jew Mordecai sitting at the king's gate." Then his wife Zeresh and all his friends said to him, "Let a gallows 50 cubits high be made, and in the morning tell the king to have Mordecai hanged on it. Then go with the king to the banquet in good spirits." This advice pleased Haman, and he had the gallows made. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We turn to our hymn books, number 471, 471. We recite this hymn, we recite the hymn, 471. We read together, "Put thou thy trust in God, in duty's path go on, walk in his strength with faith and hope, so shall thy work be done. Commit thy ways to him, thy works into his hands, and rest on his unchanging word, who heaven and earth commands. Though years on years roll on, his covenant shall endure. Though clouds and darkness hide his path, the promised grace is sure. Give to the winds thy fears, hope, and be undismayed. God hears thy sighs and counts thy tears. God shall lift up thy head. Through waves and clouds and storms, his power will clear thy way. Wait thou his time, the darkest night shall end in brightest day. Leave to his sovereign sway, to choose and to command. So shalt thou, wandering, own his way, how wise, how strong his hand." Amen. And now we have our second reading from the book of Luke.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Luke, chapter 3, reading verses 15 to 22. As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, "I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." So with many other exhortations, he proclaimed the good news to the people. But Herod the ruler, who had been rebuked by him because of Herodias, his brother's wife, and because of all the evil things that Herod had done, added to them all by shutting up John in prison. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. On page 40, we turn to our prayer books, page 40, the Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
On page 42, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us,
that we may know the joy of your salvation.
Grant peace within and among all nations,
and teach our leaders wisdom.
Endow your church with faithfulness,
and her servants with knowledge and true godliness.
Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed,
that your justice may be known among all people.
Lord, renew your spirit within us,
that in us and through us your will may be done.
We turn now page 178, our collect for the day, for the week, proper 20. Grant us, Lord, not to be anxious about earthly things, but to love things heavenly. And even now, while we are placed among things that are passing away, to hold fast to those that shall endure, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We turn back to page 45, and we pray the third collect. Into your hands, Lord, we commend ourselves this day. Let your presence be with us to its close. Strengthen us to remember that in whatever good work we do, we are serving you. Give us a diligent and watchful spirit, that we may seek in everything to know your will, and knowing it, may gladly perform it, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we turn to our hymn books once more, and we sing the hymn number 463. 463. Come thou fount of every blessing. please remember, this hymn, well, not remember, I should let you know, this hymn has four verses. Our hymn books have three verses. So the third verse will be different. Do enjoy it, and then we join back in with the last verse. So there's an extra verse. There are four verses. The third verse will be different, the third verse is the extra verse that we do not have in our hymn books. So we join back in on the last verse. 463. Come thou fount of every blessing.
Danger interposed his precious blood.
extra verse.
Oh, that day when freed from sin, I shall see thy lovely face, clothed then in blood-washed linen. How I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry. Take my ransom soul away. Send thine angels now to carry me to realms of endless day.
Last verse together now.
Oh, to grace, how great a debtor, daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy courts above. So my sisters and brothers, we would have heard in our scripture readings for today, the narrative continued, the story of Esther, as Haman makes his sinister plans to annihilate the Jews. And we can think of maybe some experience we've had or maybe currently having, where there seems to be those who plan and scheme and plot, and we, even though we've placed it in God's hands, we've placed it before God, we wonder, when will all of this be over? How is God going to work all of this out for us? And even in Jesus' day, the second reading in Luke about the baptism of Jesus also touches a bit about on the imprisonment of John the Baptist. And we see how those who choose to be faithful to God, how they are being tested and tried, being persecuted. So we have been encouraged to put our trust in God. We are reminded that the pure in heart are blessed. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So we are to remain faithful, even in our most difficult times. We are not to respond out of vexation or in anger. We still trust God. Truly not an easy calling, but with God, very, very possible, very, very doable. So as we go forth this day, whatever challenges, whatever hardships may be confronting us, let us go forth with the assurance we are not alone. Our God is with us. Our God knows all about us. Our God is indeed able. And so we pray indeed that we will remember God and acknowledge him as our fount of blessing, our fount of many uncountable blessings. So we give God thanks for another day, another week, another opportunity to worship, another opportunity to fellowship virtually. And we pray that for all of us as we gather as God's church, we pray that our coming together will indeed be a source of encouragement, and that as we eventually scatter, as we go our separate ways, We take the love of God with us wherever we go. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray today for those who seek the downfall of others. We pray for those who plot and scheme and plan to see the downfall of others, the embarrassment of others. We pray that they would have a change of heart, they would have a change of mind, that they would find greater pleasure, more meaning in seeing others lifted up, in seeing others being promoted, being blessed. And so we pray that whatever might be lacking in the lives of such persons, whatever would cause them to take joy in the pain of others, that the hand of God can and will correct such misguided understanding. We pray that we would seek rather to see others living life to the fullest, enjoying life abundantly, as Jesus has indicated to us as his purpose for coming, to bring us salvation so that we can live in the fullness of God's light and love. We pray for those who believe they are doing something good in seeking the downfall of others. We pray for God's hand to touch their hearts and minds and to show them a much different and better way to go about living our lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
So we pray today, Lord, for the release of those whose hearts and lives are consumed with revenge, those who have been hurt, those who see themselves as victims, those who believe they deserve better, those who think and believe that others who have hurt them do not deserve any kind of joy or happiness in life. Lord, we pray for that spirit of revenge and vengeance to be removed from their lives. We pray today for abundant life to touch all of us. And Lord, for those of us who may have caused the hurt and pain of others, Lord, help us to recognize the error of our ways. And help us, Lord, to have the courage and the honesty to say that we are sorry, to confess, to repent, and to seek the forgiveness of those we have hurt. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us remember to thank God. This morning we are thanking God for our Twin Island Federation of St. Kitts Nevis. We thank God for having allowed us to celebrate another year, 37. We pray, continue to pray for our leaders and all in positions of public trust and authority, all of our decision makers. We continue to pray for this worldwide pandemic touching just about every island, every nation on the face of this earth. Pray for all of our national leaders and those in positions to make decisions. We continue to remember our schools, our school children, all of our teachers and all involved in the education of our nation's children. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us also remember today to pray for the sick. We continue to lift up all of those who ask for our prayers. Remember those in hospital, those at home, those who have to travel to seek medical assistance. Remember also those who have died. Pray for their souls to be at peace with God. Pray for Almighty God to have mercy upon them. And we pray for those family members who now grieve and mourn the death of their loved ones, all of the close friends and others who feel the effect of their death. Pray for God's peace and comfort in all of their lives. Remember, most recently yesterday, pray for Dion, otherwise known as King Ayatollah, who was laid to rest, and also our brother Cuthbert Brown, also laid to rest. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And finally, we commend God's world and God's church into his hands and into his safekeeping. We pray for God's will to be done in all of our lives. And we pray for those who ask our prayers for whatever reason. We bring them before Almighty God. We lift them up. And we pray that whatever their prayer requests may be, we pray that Almighty God in his love and mercy would answer as he sees best and knows best for them. I offer prayers for all of you this morning who share with us, wherever you may be. We thank you for your fellowship. We thank you for your love. And we pray that whatever challenges any of you may go through this day, I pray Almighty God would grant you the strength, the wisdom, the courage to persevere, to endure, and to even overcome. For these and all other mercies, Lord, we pray and ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Okay, friends, our closing hymn now is number 466. 466. Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do. 466.
Father, I place into your hands the things that I can't do. Father, I place into your hands the times that I've been through. Father, I place into your hands that I should go, for I know I always can trust you. Father, I place into your hands my friends and family. Father, I place into your hands the things that trouble me. Father, I place into your hands the person I would be, for I know I always can trust you. Father, we love to seek your face, we love to hear your voice. Father, we love to sing your praise and in your name rejoice. Father, we love to walk with you and in your presence rest, for we know we always can trust you. Father, I want to be with you and do the things you do. Father, I want to speak the words that you are speaking to. Father, I want to love the ones that you will draw to you, for I know that I am one with you. For I know that I am one with you.
Oops. Father, I place into your hands, Father, we place into your hands our lives and all things. We trust you and we believe in you. We have a prayer request for Benjamin and Wellington Quealy, cousins of our dear sister Peretta, both who are ailing. We pray for God's hand upon them to bring them comfort and a peace of mind. Pray for God's hand to hold them and give them every assurance that they are not alone. Their God is with them, and the prayers of the faithful are going up for them. So we pray indeed for their minds to be at peace. Amen.
Amen.
And so we close now on page 47, page 47 of our prayer books, our prayer of dedication. Together, Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace, and at the appointed time, may they rise in glory. Amen.
Amen.
God's blessings upon you. Thank you for sharing with us this morning. You have been sharing with the Pro-Cathedral and Parish of St. George with St. Barnabas. Please remember, tomorrow evening we return at 6 p.m. That's 6 p.m. for evening prayer right here. And for those of us who are here in St. Kitts, Nevis, and well, even further afield, I will be on radio this morning, ZIZ, that is, doing a little bit of a review on our ministry presence. So about 9:15 this morning, you can tune in to ZIZ and you can maybe share any thoughts or comments about our program presence and what you think about it and anything that you think we can do better, as it were. And as we close, we ask to remember our brothers and sisters in Jamaica. We understand that the pandemic there, things seem to be increasing a bit. And that is definitely what we don't want. In the Caribbean, we are all one. I mean, worldwide, we are all one. But our little Caribbean, we really can't afford, the numbers that we see, getting sick and even dying in other countries. So we pray for the leaders there, pray for all of the health authorities, and we pray for best practices and for sound decisions. Remember always, people first, economy second or last. People first, people first, people first. So blessings and prayers to our brothers and sisters there in Jamaica. God be with you. A blessed day to all. Thank you for sharing, and do stay safe. Bye-bye.